Savannah.
All right, we're live.
Hey everyone, my name is Savannah Berry and I'm here with Carl Havens. We're with University of Florida IFAS Sea Grant and we are tagging horseshoe crabs today. So we're doing this to help out the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission collect data about horseshoe crab populations in Florida. And we're gonna take lots of measurements on this crab. We're gonna put a tag on it and then we're gonna release it. So let's get started. First, is this a male or a female crab? Well, we know this is a female because she's bigger than the male crabs and also because of her claws. She's got just the regular five claws all the same here, so we know that she is a female. So we're gonna go ahead and record that on the data sheet. And now we're gonna age her. So horseshoe crabs have a terminal molt, which means their shell degrades with age. And so we're able to give them a relative age like young, medium, or old. This is a medium crab because she's not perfect. She's got some scratches on her. And then she also has a mating scar here. So we can see that she's nested at least a few seasons. So we're gonna go ahead and age this as a medium female crab. Next, we're gonna turn her over and inspect to make sure that she has all five legs on both sides and that her tail is in good shape. And this crab looks in good condition. She doesn't have any injuries or damage. Next, we're gonna take a measurement of her prosoma so that we can get an idea of the average size of crabs in the different populations here in Florida. And as you can see, she really loves this process.
198.
Okay, so she was 198 millimeters wide, relatively middle size female here. And then next we're gonna have to get a weight on the crab. So you might be wondering, how do you weigh a horseshoe crab? Because they're really wiggly and there's no good place to attach the scale. Well, the answer is we just put them in a bag. So it's very convenient. So we've already taken the weight of this bag, so we already know how much the bag weighs. And we just use a spring scale. It's a very convenient field scale. And Carl's just gonna read the weight off.
And this one is 1150.
All right, so 1150. We'll go ahead and record that. And the last step is the tag. So the tags of a horseshoe crab are a white disc like this, and they are provided to us by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. They come in a numbered series that runs all up and down the East Coast, and horseshoe crabs are all tagged with this standard type of tag. They've got a post here on the back, so what we need to do is we need to punch a hole in the shell of the horseshoe crab so that the tag will stay put. So we just want to go ahead and put the tag here so we know right where to punch our hole. We always tag horseshoe crabs on the left side. And if you're wondering how you can get involved or help out with this data collection that we're doing, one of the best ways that you can do that is to report sightings of tagged horseshoe crabs if you're ever walking the beach. We've got people tagging horseshoe crabs all around the state. So all you have to do to report a tag is to record the tag number here. It's a 6-digit number here, right here on the base. And you can report it at this website or at the phone number 1-888-LIMULUS, which is the genus of horseshoe crab. So that's all there is to tagging a horseshoe crab. It's a pretty simple process, but it collects really important data that we need to protect this really vital species.
And is there one place where people can go to learn more about the Florida Horseshoe Crab Watch?
Yeah, we have a website on the Nature Coast Biological Station. There's a page, Florida Horseshoe Crab Watch. You can find it just by Googling those words. There's also a YouTube channel where you can find out more about what it means to be a volunteer. And if you're interested, you can contact me. You can find my contact information on the Florida Sea Grant website.
All right, thanks, Savannah.
Mm-hmm.